All right, I'm just going to jump in and feel free to join me, whoever has a mic. So to catch up, this story starts, like many of the stories in my life, as a former barista within a coffee shop. I'm sure many of us have shared this experience of being within a coffee shop. This happened to be another discussion with a resident talking about open data. It wasn't the first time I had talked about open data over coffee with a resident who was interested in what was available. But after having several of these conversations, it became clear that while open data was available, I was adding value as a human data portal. And by having a conversation back and forth where the user or this resident, this person, this actual human being could ask me questions and I could help direct them through our data portal in a way that is virtually impossible with our standard Socrata data portal, it was changing the experience for them and therefore changing the experience for the people they were trying to affect. They were interested in building new affordable housing on the East Side, an area that had been historically blighted. My timer just keeps going, so I'm just gonna keep rolling with it. They were interested in changing housing. And so this conversation was going to produce real results. So in the end, we built a chatbot, right? Because what other idea could I possibly have? Like, I'm having wonderful human interactions. How can I automate that? That probably says something about me that's not very nice. So there's only two rules. It had to be free and it had to be easy. I wasn't gonna code anything because I wanted to measure the progress of chatbots not by what's possible, but by what was easy. So we worked on this at Code for America and we consistently at night worked a little bit on it, 2 hours at a time, and probably put a total of 30 hours into it. And when we launched it, we were kind of worried about what is the worst that could happen. You know, this thing could fail miserably and turn into any of our other projects. But instead, it really started a nice conversation. And we found out that the chatbot delivers value in a way that I can't deliver value as chief data officer, right? This chatbot is around 24/7. And I was shocked to see people at 1 a.m. asking this chatbot questions about why our fiscal year starts in May. And if you ask the chatbot that question, it just shrugs at you, because that's what I would do. I don't know why it starts in May. It makes my life hard too, right? It also responds instantly, something that is far, far from my time that it takes to respond to emails. But larger than that, it started a conversation among cities. Almost immediately, other cities were calling and asking, saying, we've been thinking about this problem too, and we've been working on it in much more intelligent ways, because on a 1 to 10 scale of intelligence, this bot is at 0.5 or so, right? This is the easiest, simplest, minimal viable product we could possibly produce. But we started talking across cities about what is possible with better technology, with harder technology. What if we pooled our resources on data and used machine learning? And that's what I want to talk about is what is next when it comes to chatbots. It's not this. This little bot is a proof of concept to see how people interact. And yes, indeed, people do interact with the bot and find data resources in a way that they weren't before. But talking about what can bots do to augment our 3-on-1 service, and more than that, what can we do as cities to work together through data standards? Where's Tom? Data standards. What can we do through data standards to make these bots deployable so when they're developed in one city, they're extremely easy to deploy in other cities so that the work that Boston or Chicago are doing is easily transferable, not to just cities of my size, which is 500,000 and considered large for the Midwest, but to cities of 100,000 people or 10,000 people. That's the customer I tend to think of, is there's so many residents who don't live in the largest cities, who don't have access to this type of technology, and we can deliver it to them through things like data standards. I hope to see the next chatbots as they come out. They're going to advance very quickly. Thank you very much.